is it Ron Burgundy says?
The Human Torch was denied a bank loan. I think I'm ready now.
So we just kind of wanted to go over an overview of our 92 Miata. We actually picked this up as a shell. Pretty much nothing on it. It had some interior, no engine, no transmission, no drivetrain, period. And we bought it to originally part it out. And we had some spare parts laying around. And, you know, we kind of said, why don't we just put all the spare parts on the shell outside and see how it goes? And that's what we did. So the original plan with this was to put a 03 BBT 1.8 engine into it. And we actually had bought the whole drivetrain train with subframes and everything. It just didn't have a shell. And we were gonna do that. And then we had a 1.6 turbo parts come into our possession. And we said, you know what? We like turbos. We're gonna do a turbo. And that's what we did. And it's fantastic. And I don't regret not doing the VBT. How about you, Tyler?
No, it's absolutely perfect.
So basically the only things that we've purchased for this car are the new wheels setup, the Nine Lives Racing Wing, the Spike Performance hood vents, the hard top, the Rocket Money flares, it's a rep kit, and some things in the engine bay. And that's pretty much it. Everything else was parts we had spare from previous part outs. We've owned about 20 of these Miatas, and I think about 5 or so have been part out cars that have been rusty. And so anyway, everything that's been donated from previous cars is on here now. And it's like a hodgepodge of everything that we've collected over the years, and kind of a homage to all the Miatas that we've owned. Another thing that we did different with this build is we forced ourselves to think out of the box. And things that we don't like to do on our cars, we said, you know what? We're gonna do it on this car. We don't really care about it. If we don't like it, we can sell it or do something different. So that's exactly what we did. And it's got a rust hole down here. And it's like, you know what? Let's just learn how to autocross in this. Maybe learn how to drift, maybe go to some track days. And just as a do-all Miata and just have some fun with it. Let's talk engine bay. So what we did with the engine bay was we have a stock 1.6 motor in there. We resealed everything. And we have a Flying Miata manifold with a ISR turbo off an SR20. We have AWR 70 durometer engine mounts. We have a Fab 9 intercooler, the small one, for 350 horsepower, I think it is. We have 650cc Mustang injectors, has Kai fuel rail spacers on it. Also, we have that sweet, sweet fuse box decal that I made. Self-plug. Also, we have a Yanaka radiator with dual electric fans. I think that's pretty much it, right? We've got, yeah, custom intercooler piping. That comes with the territory. A China knockoff tile blow-off valve, a custom downpipe from the previous owner who had the turbo set up, the Mega Squirt PMP2, and oh yeah, I think that's pretty much it.
How many pounds?
What is this, Britain? We're pushing about 10 to 11 pounds right now out of the turbo, and I think it's putting us about 200 to 220 horsepower. It's pretty fun. Got a NB 5-speed transmission with a G Racing short shifter, which is absolutely amazing. We also have a Mazda speed differential with axles. We've got WorkEquip 03 wheels on here, wrapped in Falcon RT660s, 245. We did the Chase Bays brake booster delete, and we also have sport brakes, which is the biggest brake you can have for a stock Miata. On the exterior, we have a Rocket Bunny rep flare kit with a knockoff GB front lip and a Nine Lives Street Wing, which was Tyler's idea, and I hated it, and now I love it. We have the OEM hardtop and the Spike Performance hood vents. And that's pretty much it. We did the bumper cut in the back, aggressive bumper cut in the back. And yeah, honestly, exterior-wise, we really haven't done much. We've cut a lot of things. So for the interior, we have a race pack dash, which is actually really nice, but it will blind you in the middle of the night. And we have the Bride driver's seat and the Sparco Sprint passenger seat. We have the Hard Dog Ace double diagonal roll bar, which I don't really care for, but we basically got it for free, so can't complain there. And then we just have standard carpet. We did an NB dash swap. We have a Momo hub and an NRG steering wheel right now. Eventually the steering wheel will change. We have LRB half door panels that Tyler and I wrapped in black vinyl. And I also made a yellow door pull to go with it. And I think they actually turned out really good for me not liking them.